Good morning and welcome to the first ever virtual graduation commencement ceremony for Dalton L. McMichael High School and the class of 2020. I am Principal John Williams and I'm honored to be here today. Thank you to all the families, friends, and distinguished guests for being in attendance at home and online to support our graduating seniors. This is a special day. At this time, I would like to recognize special guests who, along with you, are watching at home today. From the Rockingham County Schools Board of Education, Paula Rakestraw, Board Chair, Bob Wyatt, Vice Chair, Amanda Bell, Brent Huss, Doug Isley, Kimberly McMichael, and our newest RCS Board of Education member, Vicki McKinney. In addition to our board members, I would like to recognize Dr. Rodney Shotwell, RCS Superintendent of Schools, the administrative staff of Rockingham County Schools, the County Commissioners of Rockingham County, and our elected civic leaders from Mayodan, Madison, and Stoneville. Thanks again to all of you. You have been instrumental in playing a part in the success of our seniors both in and out of the classroom. Again, we thank you. Before we move on in the program, it is tradition at McMichael to recognize our current Teacher of the Year. Mr. John Butler served as our 2019-2020 Teacher of the Year and earned this distinction through his countless hours of working with our STEM program, robotics program, TSA program here at McMichael. Through his leadership, our students have yielded numerous state and national competition awards this year and in years past. Thank you, Mr. Butler, for your service to our students and staff. At this time, I would like to introduce Senior Molly Williams for some opening words of reflection, and this will be followed by a musical piece sung by Olivia Gann.
Hey seniors, this is Molly. I'm here talking to you today because we are graduating. Being here today is just an honor in itself. In the state of the world today, we become more grateful for the things we have and appreciate those around us. The people who go through the greatest trials become more successful and stronger people. If this pandemic has taught us anything, it would be that we have to cherish what we have and appreciate the time we are given with our family and friends. If you take anything away from this day, I want you to remember this. Through all the obstacles you jump over and all the struggles you are going through, you are amazing and strong enough to fly through them. You are strong enough to get up and hope for a better day. The class of 2020 has been through a lot, but we will all learn from this and become stronger people. You cannot let your struggles and difficulties define who you are. I am proud to be a 2020 graduate and to graduate with the best of friends. Thank you.
When you look back on times we've had, I hope you smile and know that through the good and through the bad, I was on your side, and nobody could hold us down. We claimed the brightest star, and we came so far, and no, they won't forget. Whenever you remember times gone by, remember how we held our heads so high, when all this world was there for us, and we believed that we could touch the sky. Whenever you remember, I'll be there. Remember how we reached that dream together. Whenever you remember, when you look back on things we've done, I hope you're proud. When you look back and see how far we've come, it was our time to shine, and nobody could hold us down. They thought they'd see us fall, but we stood so tall, and no, they won't forget. Whenever you remember times gone by, remember how we held our heads so high, when all this world was there for us, and we believed that we could touch the sky. Whenever you remember, I'll be there. Remember remember how we reached that dream together. Whenever you remember, came so far, you know that we showed them all, and no, they won't forget. Whenever you remember times gone by, remember how we held our heads so high when all this world was there for us, and we believed that we could touch the sky. Whenever you remember, I'll be there. Remember how we reached that dream together. Whenever you remember. Whenever you
Thank you, Olivia. At this time, I would like to introduce our senior class president and keynote speaker, Gabe Capel.
What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome to the virtual graduation of the class of 2020. I would like to begin by congratulating my fellow seniors in the class of 2020 for making it to this graduation that there is like no other. I would also like to thank Rockingham County Schools for their endless efforts to make our graduation the best that it can be. Over the past couple of months, we've had to adapt to so many unexpected changes in our lives. Through these changes, I've been inspired to keep going from my favorite basketball player of all time, Kobe Bryant. He said, "Life is too short to get bogged down and be discouraged. You have to keep moving. You have to keep going. Put one foot in front of the other, smile, and just keep on rolling." As our class has faced many different obstacles and challenges in the last 4 years, we've done our best to smile and just keep on rolling. Of course, this graduating class has been unique from the beginning. Most of us were born during the time surrounding our country's worst terrorist attack since Pearl Harbor, that of course being 9/11. Over the next 17 to 19 years, we have faced hardships in our families and in our communities. So many lost lives during our high school years. Let's also not forget our classmates that have fallen at our time at McMichael. Classmates like Celine Alamary, Brady Mitchell, and Bailey Martin will forever have left their imprint on our lives. And now, we have had our senior year forever altered by the worldwide pandemic of COVID-19. We will get over not having a prom or a live graduation right now, but the virus itself will shape us into the people, the citizens, and the generation that we will become. We are more stronger, more unified, and more familiar with just how harsh and just how beautiful life can really be. Throughout our journey the last 12 years, we have definitely not traveled alone. At this time, I would like to thank all the teachers, parents, administrators, coaches, grandparents, family and friends that have helped us to keep on rolling and who have cared for us throughout our journey. They have cheered, pushed, and fought for us every step of the way. I bet if you asked me on the first day of kindergarten what our lives would look like on graduation day, none of us would have predicted this. I would have told you easily that I would be in the NBA by now. In fact, I held on to that dream way past kindergarten. Last month, I got an awesome surprise in my mailbox from my sixth grade English teacher, Ms. Fitzgerald. Like a lot of you, I have forgotten that in sixth grade, we wrote letters to our future 12th grade selves. Mine starts out, "Dear Kobe, did Kobe get his sixth ring, and how many rings does LeBron have?" In the letter, I go on to say that I have an iPhone 5, and I am about to get the Xbox One. On that day, Ms. Fitzgerald was playing Happy by Pharrell Williams. And the popular things at the time were the Roshi Runs, the Yeet, twerking, the PS4, and the Xbox One. When I got the letter, I have to admit, I was a little excited, a little amused, and it really felt bittersweet. My first thought was that Kobe did not get six rings, and now he never would. And then I thought about the memories that we have missed in the last few months. Just being together in the halls and at lunch, at baseball games and softball games, track practice, prom, and senior day, when we get to go back and visit our elementary schools wearing our cap and gowns while the little kids in the halls clap for us. So many memories missed. And then I realized what an incredible gift Ms. Fitzgerald had given us. She cared enough to make us write letters at a time where we could have not have known how much they would mean to us. She kept the letters for six school years and then mailed them to us in the middle of a pandemic. She cared enough back then to want good memories for us now. And I bet every single person in our class has had at least one teacher in the last 12 years that cared enough about their students beyond assignments, test scores, and grades. Maybe they just listened or made an assignment more fun than you thought it would be. Maybe it was the way they shared something about themselves that made them seem more as humans and not just teachers. So to all the Ms. Fitzgeralds, Dr. Poplins, Ms. Brakeleys, and Ms. Calverts, and to all great teachers, we thank you. We appreciate you more than we know, and definitely more than we might have shown. In kindergarten, everyone is nervous, excited, and everybody wants to be successful. We color inside the lines, practice using safety scissors, and try to learn to read. In kindergarten, we think that we will be honor students, star athletes, and homecoming queens. We looked up to the big kids who drove cars, played sports, and wore the McMichael Phoenix blue and gold. And just like we dreamed, a large number of us have been successful at McMichael. For our graduating class, we have well over $4 million in scholarships. But as this worldwide shutdown has shown us, the definition of what it takes to be successful has many layers. For every healthcare worker, there are cleaning staff, maintenance staff, bus drivers, and cafeteria workers that keep the hospitals open. We have been reminded just how much our country depends on truck drivers, grocery store stockers, and line cooks at our favorite restaurants. In America, we are supposed to be united, all in this together. And even though this is not the senior year we expected or the graduation ceremony we wanted, as a class of 2020, we are united by our unique circumstances. The students that rise to the top academically or athletically are always going to get recognition. But what about the student today who is graduating even though they may not have had a stable household or food to eat? What about the students with a C average who has taken care of their elderly relatives or younger siblings or worked almost a full-time job in high school? Or the students who grew up in houses where English was not their first language? In some ways, these are the most successful people in our class. Every one of us knows of someone who is always smiling, always kind, always willing to listen or help someone out. Every one of us knows of at least one classmate like J.T. Milner or Michael Stevens, who remind us that we may have all had different abilities, but a loving heart and a happy spirit that brings joy can be the most important energy that there is. Graduation is a time for every one of us to celebrate this milestone and dream about what happens next. There are a million different kinds of people and a million different ways to be useful and successful in this world. Let's show the world that we keep on rolling. We know we can make our lives more peaceful, more just, and more successful in every way imaginable, because the future belongs to us, the 2020 class of Fighting Phoenix. Thank you.
Thank you, Gabe. Every graduating class is special in its own way. For you, you will always be known as the class of COVID-19. No other McMichael class has had a year quite like yours. Many things were taken from you. Your last prom, spring sports, the Legally Blonde spring musical, Vex Robotics Worlds, National Marksmanship Competition, a senior trip to Carowinds, numerous other field trips, a face-to-face on-time graduation, and much, much more. Through all of this, your class has been strong. You have been leaders and have shown a caring spirit in helping your family and others, all while maintaining social distance. Through this pandemic, we have had seniors return to finish their degrees through remote learning, and your class looks to have the highest graduation rate of any former class of the Fighting Phoenix. During these trying times, your class has earned over $6 million in awarded scholarships. 170 students have been accepted to a 2 or 4 year institution. 28% of our graduates plan to go to a 4 year school such as UNC Chapel Hill, NC State, UNC Greensboro, UNC Charlotte, East Carolina University, Western Carolina University, Salem College, Shaw University, Winston-Salem State, North Carolina Central, Guilford College, and the U.S. Air Force Academy, and others as well. 51% of our students plan to attend a 2 year school such as RCC, DTCC, Forsyth Tech, Cape Fear Community College, Surrey Community College, Patrick Henry Community College, and others. 3 students are enlisted in the military to serve our country, and 20% plan to enter the workforce if they haven't already. Lastly, we have 3 seniors who will be rocket-top apprentices who will work, get paid, attend RCC for an associate's degree, all for free in the pursuit of a full-time job upon completion of the program. We have some pretty amazing students here at McMichael. We have missed you, we will miss you, and just know that you are going to do great things once you leave here. You will make our Phoenix family very proud. Wish all of you the very best, and I know each of you will be successful in your future endeavors. So, to the graduating class of 2020, I leave you with the following quote from former tennis great Arthur Ashe. Start where you are, use what you have, do what you can. At this point, we have come to the most important part of our morning, the awarding of diplomas. On May 30th, we held our first ever senior celebration graduation parade. During this parade, one graduate was able to exit their car, receive their diploma cover, and walk across the stage as their name and honors were called out by our Teacher of the Year, Mr. John Butler. At this point in the broadcast, you will see pictures of our 215 graduates, followed by some additional graduate remarks from senior Jaden Graves, and then the turning of the tassels.
Thank you. first off, props to all the graduates and Gabe for that great speech, and real love to my man Kobe, one of the greatest on the basketball court, hands down. It's fitting that we get our senior quote from Kobe, a man who made a name for himself and has numbers to prove it. It's safe to say he's living in a paradise of his own. But do you want to know why Kobe is so renowned in the first place? It was never just his raw, uncut talent with a basketball. It was his mob mentality, a mentality that never puts limitations on accomplishing any given thing, a mentality that is all about focusing on the process and trusting in the hard work when it matters most. Kobe knew that in order to do great things, we must get our hands dirty and make experiences for ourselves, whether the outcome is good or bad. We have to be risk takers in life to get what we want. In the end, success is not about having athleticism, wealth, or talent. It is a mindset and strategy. So seniors, we have to work and put effort into whatever it is that we're doing, because nothing comes free in life. Don't hold things off, because before you know it, hours turn into days and days turn into weeks. You have to put one foot in front of the other and just do it. At the end of the day, the only thing holding you back from your success is yourself. So get your Mamba attitude on, and remember that time waits on no one.
Thank you, Jaden. Graduates, I'm proud of you and everything you've accomplished thus far at your time here at Dalton L. McMichael High School. Always remember your Phoenix pride, and good luck in all your future pursuits in college, the military, and in the workforce. Once a Phoenix, always a Phoenix. Traditionally, the tassel was worn on the right side of the mortarboard to represent the students that have not yet graduated, and then it is moved once students have received their diplomas. At this time, with the class of 2020, please stand where you are. By the power vested in me by the state of North Carolina, I now pronounce you 2020 graduates of Dalton L. McMichael High School. Please turn your tassel to the left. Seniors, keep on rolling.